Today we are going to start out with scales. You guys are going to play D major with your right hand, D major scale, and then with your left hand you're going to play its relative minor. I'm going to see if, Kat, if you can tell me, what is D major's relative minor?
D major's relative minor would be B minor?
Very good! Gladius, what sharps do D major and B minor share in common?
C sharp and F sharp.
Very good. Okay. Who would like to go first today? Playing the scales. All right, Gladius, come on up. Kira, can you play D major scale for me, please? Can you play B minor for me now? So there are odd intervals and there are even intervals, right? So for example, Kat, what would an odd interval be?
An odd interval would be one that is an odd number away from one note.
Yeah, so like what, give me an example of an odd interval.
Like five, fifth harmonic.
Perfect, yeah, or like a third, right, Kira? If you have an even interval. It'd
be a 2 second.
Good job, Kira, good job. So I'm gonna show you guys an even interval, and I want to see if you can pick up on the pattern, okay? So here's an even. This is a fourth because four is an even number. Can you try to describe this pattern for me?
One's on the line and one is in a space.
Yeah, good. So every even interval contains two different notes. One is on a space, one is on a line. If you have an odd interval, how would you describe this pattern, Kira?
They're both in the space.
Yeah. And what about this odd interval? This is a seventh.
They're both on a line.
Very good. We're going to do a little activity where I show you guys two different intervals, and you're going to identify it by saying the number of steps. So if it's a second, a third, a fourth, but you're going to use the even and the odd patterns to help you identify it. Kat, can you please identify this interval for me?
Fourth harmonic.
Very good, Kat. And Kira?
Sixth harmonic.
Very good! About good. Doing great. Let's keep going. Gladius and Marie, you guys are doing such a great job with identifying intervals with the even and odd patterns. So I think you're ready to move on to the next part of the unit. I'm going to teach you guys today about perfect intervals. Perfect intervals have only one basic form. The first, fourth, fifth, and eighth are all perfect intervals. They're considered perfect because they just sound very resolved. They sound just perfect, essentially. We're going to apply your new knowledge of perfect intervals by choosing a key from this bucket. So for example, if you choose A minor, to come up with a fourth interval in A minor, and that'll be one of the perfect intervals. You choose a key card.
B flat minor.
Okay, so just choose any notes in there that can make a fourth interval, and then we got perfect.
B flat and E flat.
So would that be considered a perfect interval?
Yes, it would.
G minor.
I'm gonna test your knowledge. What's another perfect interval? We know fourth is considered perfect.
Oh, fifth.
Very good. So I want you to think of two notes. In unit. So I thought it might be helpful to go over the scale degrees. Because if you can understand scale degrees better, it's a little bit easier to identify the different modes, okay? Let's say that the green sticky represents the first degree and the orange sticky represents the second degree. Okay, we're gonna use C major scale for a little example, all right? What degree is C in the key of C major?
C is first, also known as the root.
Nice.
Then D would be second, and E would be third, and so on.
Very good. Okay, so what we're going to do now, we're going to do a little bit of transposing in a way. Now that you've kind of said the scale degrees of C major, we're going to do the same with D. D major scale. I want you to take the green sticky, because that's our first degree sticky, and I want you to place that on the first degree D major.
So it would be D.
Nice! And what would be the second degree of D major?
The second degree would be E.
Nice! Okay, now I'm going to try to bring in a little bit of the modes, okay? The mode that starts on the first degree of a scale is called the Ionian. Do you remember the Ionian?
Yes.
Yeah. So you would say, if you start on D, that's the Ionian of D. But if you start on E, that's the Dorian, because Dorian starts on the second degree. What was the first degree of C major again?
That would be C.
Nice. So what is that Ionian mode in C major?
It would be...
Remember, Ionian starts on the first degree.
So the Ionian would be C.
Very good! High five, Kat. Okay, Kira, so you know we've been in the modes unit for jazz lately, and I know you've been struggling a bit. It might be helpful, I think, to go over the C minor pentatonic scale. I'm gonna play it for you real quick, because sometimes, you know, it just helps to look and listen to it, so. So we're just gonna go over the notes that are included from this middle C up to that C, okay? And do you remember the three finger grip? So you're gonna be using that, only your 1, 2, and 3. We're gonna use some stickies. I want you to stick that on middle C, please. Stick this on the G that comes right after C. Good. Wherever there are stickies, that's your starting point. That's what you're gonna play with your one finger, your thumb, okay? So I want you to try that. Nice! And then you do the same thing an octave higher. Nice, girl! High five, Kira. Woo! Gladys, you've been doing a great job in our modes unit. I just want to double check your knowledge, see where you're at, so we know where to go from here, okay? We're gonna use B minor scale in this little activity. I want you to tell me, what is the Dorian mode in B minor?
C sharp.
Very good. If you were to play that mode scale, it would look like this. You see how it sounds a little bit different from B minor, but you're using the same notes that B minor uses. What is the Phrygian mode in B minor?
Is it D?
Yes, very good, because it's the third scale degree. Can you play that for me, please? You forgot C sharp.
Oh, is it just D?
So it's okay. Essentially D major.
Okay.
Yeah, can you play that? Third, one crosses under. Very good, so that's the Phrygian mode. All right, let's move on to the next one. Okay, Marie, I know that these mode names are super weird, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. They are confusing. They're all these weird Latin words that we've never used before. But in order to really get our modes down, it's crucial that you can remember which scale degree the certain mode starts on. We're just gonna test your memory, run through this, see how it goes, okay? So the Ionian mode, which scale degree does the Ionian mode start on?
The first.
Nice, very good. What about the Lydian mode?
Fourth.
Good. Ao this is always hard to say. Aeolian. Aeolian, I can't even say it.
The second?
You need to add four more to that. It is the sixth degree, yeah. So, Aeolian. I'm gonna put that back into our pile and we'll review it again, okay? The Locrian. Guys, this is super exciting because the interval unit is almost over. And I think a great way to end this interval unit is by having you guys show me what you have learned so far. And you guys can choose how you're going to demonstrate your knowledge to me. Some ideas that I thought of, you can compose a song using different types of intervals. So you can, you know, have some melodic in there, some harmonic, second, third, all that good stuff. You can choose a piece of music and point out the different intervals that are included in there. And it can literally be any piece of music as long as it's appropriate, right? You can make a music video explaining intervals. Oh, this is a fun one. You can create some kind of like game or activity, you know, uses intervals. It's really up to you. Just based off of what I just told you guys, do you guys have any ideas or do you have any questions?
An essay.
You could write. No. Yeah, you could write an essay. You could. Seriously, it could be any. It could be anything. You could draw a picture. You could paint a picture at different intervals.
Make an illustration.
You could do a poster board.
You can do a poster board, yeah. It's perfect, I love it. Good luck with your project, and we'll be working on this for a few days, and I'm really excited to see you guys come up with it. Well, I started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone. And the sun went down as across the hill, and the town lit up, the world got still. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't